Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are talking about dates, and in particular with regards to pivot tables, because in the newer versions of Excel, when you do change a table of data into a pivot table, sometimes they reformat the date to months and years, and sometimes we'd actually like the date in the results, not the summarized data into months and years. So let's get started. This is just a simple table of motor vehicle sales with the salesperson, the type of vehicle, quantity and value. So we'll go ahead and change this into a pivot table. So first things first is to highlight the table. Go up to the ribbon to insert, select pivot table, make sure it's selected on new worksheet, press OK. So a new sheet has popped up with the pivot table and the field headings that we selected. So the first thing I'm going to grab is I would like to sum the quantity of motor vehicles. So I'm going to grab that field and put it into the values section. And I want to see that total value of quantity, or the sum of the quantity by date. So I'm going to grab the date and put that into the rows. And as you can see, it's summarized the dates into years with a couple of crosshairs where you can open it up to quarter and it goes down to month. So it's actually summarized the dates into years, quarters and months. Now this isn't always what you want to do. How do I get those actual individual dates on there? Why did it disappear? Well, it's actually a really easy fix and I'll show you how it's done. So it's quite simple actually. You pretty much go straight to one of the cells where there is a date or a year currently in there. You right click in there and one of the options is to ungroup. You select that and now all the individual dates that were from your original set of data have now appeared in the pivot table. And just quickly before I show you how to readjust these dates into your own format how you'd like to see it, please hit that subscribe button or that like button, really appreciate it. So to get the dates back into the grouped format, again, select any date or any cell with a date in it, right click, and you can actually go back into the group function and you can actually select which options you'd like to see. So here you can see I've selected years and months. I'll press OK and now you've got the years and the months summarized. So there you go, as simple as that, changing dates with the new Excel into the formats that you'd like to see. Hope it helped and hope to see you again.